Now owned by Lenovo, these new Moto Z phones are a new take on the modular smartphone. So this is the new Moto Z Play, no longer using the Motorola brand since Lenovo bought the company, which is the cheaper out of the two new Moto Z phones, and it comes in at £369, so quite a middling price there, not budget, not premium. Starting with the design, which we're really impressed with, it's got a feel and a look that is of a premium phone, a lot more expensive, so we've got this combination of metal running around the edge and a nice glass back. Now the Moto Z Play is a little bit thicker and heavier than the Moto Z, so this is 7mm according to Lenovo, although we've measured it at 7.2, and the more expensive Moto Z, which comes in at £499, is just 5mm 0.2 thick. Obviously the Z Play being a bit thicker does mean it's heavier, but it's no brick at 165 grams, while the Moto Z is just 136. One of the main things to talk about this phone is this huge metal contact at the bottom, which almost looks like a bit of an accident, but it's there for a really good reason, and this is because it's a modular phone. So if we just pick up one of the accessories here, this is the JBL speaker, which you can pick up for £69. You literally just snap the two together and you're ready to go. There's no Bluetooth pairing, anything like that, and this one has a little handy kickstand so you can watch your films, although obviously the sound's going to come out the back. And anytime you don't want this accessory to be on the phone, because obviously it does make it pretty darn big and heavy, you just pull it off and pop it in your bag. There are a couple of other options when it comes to the Moto Mods, that's what they're called, and this is the Hasselblad True Zoom, so this is for photography nuts, and this one comes in at a fairly pricey £199. So when we snap this one on, it becomes more like a traditional camera, and we've got some buttons and controls here for the camera. If you're someone that uses optical zoom a lot, this Hasselblad gives you times 10 optical zoom, so that's something that you're not going to get on any other phone out there at the moment. Just remember to put the lens away before you take it off, because it's powered by the phone. So the other ones that we don't have at the moment are a projector, which is £249, and there's also a battery pack, which is just £59 if you want a bit of extra battery life. Now Lenovo also has these style shells. One comes in the box, and this is just the basic fabric option. Again, this just snaps on via the magnets. Takes away the camera bump, gives you a bit of extra grip because the glass is quite slippery, and you can get this in various colours and styles. So there's also leather and wood options if you're willing to pay £20 per shell, and they're really nice. So we really like the modular system of the Moto Z and the Moto Z Play, but let's just move on to some of the specs, because you might not know which phone to buy. So the Moto Z Play comes with a 5.5 inch screen, same size as the Moto Z, so that the accessories fit, but this you're going to get a full HD screen rather than a quad HD, and inside you're going to get a Qualcomm Snapdragon 625 processor instead of a 820. You're going to get 3GB of RAM, 32GB of storage, and no SD card slot. Now when it comes to the cameras, we've got a 16 megapixel camera on the Moto Z Play, which is actually more megapixels than the Moto Z, but there's no optical image stabilization here, and on the front there's a 5 megapixel camera including a flash, so you can even do your selfies in the dark. Now as I mentioned earlier, there's a bigger battery inside the Moto Z Play because it's thicker, and that's 3510 mAh compared to 2600, so you're going to get much better battery life and that headphone jack if you want to listen to music without using your Bluetooth headphones. Like most other Android phones, we're using the latest reversible USB-C port, and like the cheaper Moto G4 phone, we've got this little fingerprint scanner on the front of the phone, which is quite small, but it works well and accurately, as you can see, and you can use it to both unlock and lock the phone. One frustrating thing is that when you're in an app, it feels quite natural to use it as a home button, but it won't do anything. You've got to use the on-screen button, so that can get a little bit frustrating. We're really impressed with the Moto Z and the Moto Z Play and the Moto Mod system of having a modular phone. It works so easy. You can choose which accessories you want and you don't want. And these are stylish, well-designed phones with good hardware and software. We award 4 stars.